The Philippine government assures farmers measures are in place to help those who would be affected by the El Nino phenomenon. The irrigation agency says government agencies have committed to roll out cash for work or livelihood programs.
Talagang walang pag-asa. Di ba natin worst case scenario, may talagang hindi makapagtanim. Diyan po papasok po, sir, ang DSWD. Kasama po sa team namin ang DSWD para sa kanilang assistance, sa task forward program, ang dole naman yung kanilang tupad program para mabigyan ng extra income, trabaho ng ating mga farmers.
The Philippine Energy Chief points to inadequacies in the country's transmission system for Monday's power interruption in Luzon. Secretary Rafael Lutilla said this was also to blame for the power outages in Panay and in Negros over the past weeks. The Energy Department urges the grid operator to fast-track the completion of its projects and maintenance to avoid outages during the summer. It also ordered the agency to submit an official explanation on the incident. An initial probe by the NGCP showed the interruption was triggered by the tripping off of the Masinloc-Bolo transmission line. It says it's working with personnel at the Masinloc power plant to prevent a repeat of the incident. Justice Secretary Rimulya meanwhile revealed he has received a second surrender feeler from former Bureau of Corrections Chief Gerald Bantag. The first was sent through a cabinet official and the other was through the Justice Secretary's friend. But Rimulya doubts Bantag is serious about surrendering. The disgraced prison's bureau chief is charged with the murder of veteran broadcaster Percy Lapid and Bilibid inmate June Villamor. Warrants for the arrest of Bantag and his deputy, Ricardo Solweta, have been issued.
A joint committee at the House of Representatives begins an investigation into the sinking of MT Princess Empress of the waters of Oriental Mindoro, causing a massive oil spill. Vivian Gulia joins us on the line for more. Viv?
High lawmakers questioned how MT Princess Empress was allowed to sail despite the absence of a certificate of public convenience. It sank off Oriental Mindoro's waters last February and caused a massive oil spill. Philippine Coast Guard Commandant Admiral Artemio Abu told the Joint House Committees investigating the incident that agents of MT Princess Empress presented documents showing that the vessel was allegedly new and that Marina supposedly decided to approve its CPC. The PCG admitted it does not have the capability to immediately determine the authenticity of the documents. It added that the oil tanker had at least 17 voyages before the incident. The Maritime Industry Authority denied it issued the said decision and asserted that no CPC was issued for MT Princess Empress. Justice Undersecretary Raul Vasquez said that the National Bureau of Investigation's probe, the documents presented to the PCG by the tanker's agents were questionable, noting that the vessel was not brand new. Barzaga said complaints should be filed for falsification of documents. Vasquez, for his part, says the DOJ is finalizing the case buildup for filing criminal, civil, and administrative complaints against those who may have contributed to the sinking of the MT Princess Empress. He expects to begin filing the complaints in 2 weeks. The PCG, meanwhile, recommended the amendment of the RA 9993 or the Philippine Coast Guard Law and the passage of the PCG Modernization Law and the enactment of an national oil spill contingency plan. The committees plan to invite the owner of the MT Princess Empress in the next hearing. The owner was no-show in the first hearing of the committee this morning. It also will summon the agents who presented the allegedly falsified documents, and it requires the ship captain's physical presence in the next hearing. Back to you.
Thanks, Viv.